insistent Ferengi has been trying to make new trade deals with us since he first visited our system. Well, everything he tries to sell is either broken or worthless. Thank you. It's good to see you again, and under much better circumstances. You'll be happy to know that our star... The decision to explore was somewhat controversial, however. Many Lucari were... resistant to the notion. We settled this moon long ago, after we were forced to leave our dying homeworld of Kentar. It was a... difficult. Still, the exploration initiative passed. Considering my experience, my people have chosen me to command the LSS Concordium. It was an honor I proudly accepted. Our ship is ready to go, and you are. For our maiden voyage, I've chosen a star that is close enough to be within reach, but still just outside the area of space that you've explored, and obviously one that we haven't visited yet. According to your star charts, it's a yellow-white star called 20 Draconis. Of the system. There's a large field of rocky debris and asteroids. We're picking up various metals and crystalline formations. Should we approach one of the larger asteroids and take some more? Readings coming in now. Sensors are picking up some movement on the far side of the asteroid. Not simple orbiting debris either. Beautiful. Intriguing. The Gekli communicate using... We've adjusted our power system. An excellent idea. Data's coming in from the Gekli. I'd like to expand the number of tagged subjects to optimize data collection. Let's get close enough to slip in with a pod and join them in their swimming. Up readings from all of the creatures. They're treating us like one of their own. They're trying to talk to us with their radio waves.
That was incredible. What a singular experience.
We've spotted a larger group of them in an area not too far from here. This looks like a feeding ground for several Gekli pods. Let's go have a look. There's some kind of subspace shearing here. It's causing cosmic strings to snap off and break up the asteroids. That must be why the Gekli feed here. There's plenty of particulate matter for them to consume in the debris fields. I think we... passing by this stellar body. They look to have an orbital period of about 173 of your standard years. I'd like to know if they came from outside of the system and were caught in its gravity, or if they originated here.
reach the ice. There they are. Magnificent, aren't they? The creatures are luminescent ovoids? Interesting. These life forms were encountered by the USS Enterprise D on Deneb 4, someplace called Farpoint Station. They haven't been seen anywhere else since. The color display must be a form of communication. I didn't realize that life forms could exist in this fashion, living off the heat of planets, feeding on the particles in space, absorbing radiation from the cosmos. There's so much to see. Let's head to the next planet in the system and see what's there. Seeing this? My sensors indicate this planet is completely devoid of any organic material, and yet it has a breathable atmosphere and lies well within the system's habitable zone. Most curious. I'm picking up residual levels of radiation. Oh my. I believe I know what happened to this world. Some kind of proto-matter wave happened here. Not if you know how to resolve the chaotic turbulence with a tarphene reduction. This was a recent event. Some kind of proto-matter incident happened, and it wiped out all life on the planet. I think we should send an away team down to learn more.
I'll ever get used to transporters. Let's see. Initial scans suggest this area used to be inhabited, but I can't find a single trace of organic matter. None. The walls of this... Look, there's some kind of large structure further down the canyon. Look at the size of that plaza. These people must have had quite a developed culture. Let's just take some readings up there.
Square or...
These murals depict people. This mural depicts the construction of this large structure. I suspect it was a temple or a place of contemplation for the people. The crystals depicted in this mural are quite the enigma.
We could.
Yes, it would be based. Were used with opposable thumbs and indicate a likely hand span of 22 centimeters. Based on these footprints, these people had a stride that places them at about 1.6 meters on average. The wear patterns here show us that people leaned against here frequently. This was a meeting and gathering area.
Strange.
Yes. The evidence seems clear. The proto-matter detonation happened only weeks, perhaps even days ago. We're going to need to make an accurate simulation to continue our studies here. I suggest using modified pattern enhancers to do this. Enhancers online. The signal is strong and clear. Two down, two to go. That's three. One more and we'll be ready. That's the last one. All enhancers online and standing by. All right. The enhancers should give us pretty good image range. Your tricorder can then act as the center of the network control for the enhancers. I can note that the alien is using the pillars in a specific order. They're making the murals match up on each pillar. Looks like some kind... set in place. Two pillars set into place. Three pillars are locked in now. That's it! It's working! Well done! Shall we see what secrets this building holds? I think I... Isn't that the symbol of your Starfleet? How did it get here? How could it be in a temple of people who don't even have electricity, much less space travel? This is getting stranger by the minute. Those people in the picture, they don't look like the others. What happened here? If Starfleet officers contacted this civilization in the past, why wouldn't you have a record of it? We should head deeper into the temple and continue. I think the panel on the wall here can be pushed. Those inner doors across from the panel are opening. We've reached ground zero. This is where someone detonated the protomatter bomb. From here, a self-propagating cascade of proto-energy radiated outward in all directions, washing over the entire planet. Doubtful. I believe what did this was built specifically as a weapon. There's no new ecosystem. All life was... I'm picking up a residual energy signature here. Take a look. 16 centimeter wavelength with a slight kaon leak. I've seen this before. It's a byproduct of Zenkethi technology.
engineer's log. Chief engineer's log. Engineer's log. Chief Engineer's log, April 17th, 1570. Today we visited the planet we're calling Draconis 3 to collect supplies. The good news, there's a humanoid civilization down there. Bad news, a potential Prime Directive violation. Our landing party was seen beaming in by some of the locals. We're hoping that doesn't impact their culture in any way. One thing's for sure, they can't help us go home. Their tech level is Bronze Age at best.
will to get what he wants. In spite of that, I feel like we've learned so much out here. And for the better. Indeed. I'd say our first flight was a success. Now we need to share our discoveries with everyone back home. I hope today's events will convince my people of the continued need to explore and to be part of the galactic community. With luck, we'll do this again sometime, and soon. On behalf of the Lucari people,